and this is Kiss Fist. One minute. I forgot to introduce him. This is Kevin. Hi. Whatever. He's deaf as well. I'm deaf and I'm proud of it. He's proud of it too. We're both proud. This is my background information. I was born and grew up in Buffalo, New York. I moved here my junior year. When I was born, they found out I was deaf. When I was very young, I used hearing aids. And I could hear a little, but not well. So eventually, I got a cochlear implant, and it improved my hearing so much. I used to wear a backpack. It's very old school design. It had a long wire that connected this device and then connected to my cochlear implant. And it bothered me. It was heavy on my back and it was awkward. And now technology is so much better. I don't need to wear the backpack. And I can communicate without being burdened down. I got my cochlear somewhere around 6 or 7 years old. And I went to school for the deaf in New York. The common reasons why people become deaf or lose their hearing: exposure to loud noise, head trauma, viruses or meningitis, which causes a high fever, autoimmune inner ear disease, illnesses, hearing loss that runs in families, chronic ear infections, birth defects, genetics. We have no idea why I'm deaf. Those are two of my really good friends. We grew up together and were really tight, but we've lost contact and everybody's moved. That's me. Check out my hair. Okay. The reason I went to residential school for the deaf, it's both for deaf and hard of hearing. It's get incredible language acquisition and develop cultural identity. That's my school, St. Mary's School for the Deaf. Typically, deaf children start their educational journey when they're young. 1 or 2 years old. I started when I was around 3 in the deaf infant program. When I was 5, I enrolled full time and I lived there for the week, Monday through Friday, and then I went home on the weekends to visit my parents. We ate our meals there, we did sports, homework, and all kinds of fun school activities. At my school for the deaf, that's where I found my true deaf identity. I learned who I was and what being deaf meant. I lived in a dorm, I had a wonderful dorm life, friends, ASL development, there was sports, we had track and basketball and running and soccer. All kinds of different activities. We went to the mall, we played Color Wars. My favorite was their large screen TV, and we'd watch it in this room with a huge projector, and it had captioning for the deaf. It was really nice, it was perfect. Here I'm talking about residential school for the deaf where I went versus a school like here. So the reason we use the term EYETH, E-Y-E-T-H, for residential school for the deaf is deaf people use their eyes, where hearing people use their ears, see earth. And in a deaf school, you sit in a circular U shape so everybody can see. And at a school for the deaf, you don't have to worry about communicating. Everybody there signs. We share the same culture, we share the same values, and all my friends are like me. In a mainstream school, which West Charlotte is, I'm dependent on my interpreter, as Kevin is as well. So when I take notes, it's really hard. I miss information. And the interpreter doesn't match me. I mean, I'm black, I'm a guy, she's a white woman. And English is my second language. So think about it. Earth, E-A-R-T-H, hearing people use their ears, but in a world called Eith, E-Y-E-T-H, we use our eyes, everything is visual. It's two worlds, the deaf world and the hearing world. Let me explain to you what deaf culture is. Deaf culture is a set of social beliefs, behaviors, art, literacy, traditions, history, values, and shared institutions of communities that are influenced by deafness, which uses sign language as a very, very important means of communication for the deaf and hard of hearing as well. For accessibility, to go to the doctor, anything you need, you have to communicate. Communication is the key to everything. There are more than 70 million deaf people in the world. That means I'm not alone. We're not alone. There's a lot more people like us. Kevin. This was for our club yesterday. And if you're interested in coming, we meet every Thursday and we teach ABCs, numbers. Let me explain what Kiss Fist means. So I'm kissing the back of my fist. That means you really love something. Like, I love basketball, so I would sign, I love food, if you love food or anything that's connected to something you really, really like. And you just kiss the back of your fist and then that thing that you like. I'm teaching ABCs, and Miss Wyatt is going. We're going to give her the picture of the ABCs. Do you have one? In here, you said.
It's right there on that.
It won't stay up.
Oh. See, ABCs. So later, I'm gonna teach you some signs. I'm doing A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, and Z. Ta-da! So that's basically, you know, you just gotta practice and memorize it, so, and pick it up. I'm teaching numbers. Here's numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. But I've noticed that people who hear tend to say it like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. But deaf people do it a different way. It's easier to use it on one hand. And there's all kinds of different introductions we use, like this is hello, how are you? Good morning. Good afternoon. Things like that we've been learning in the club. You ready, Kevin? The famous deaf people in the world that I'd like to share with you. I'm not sure if you've seen her before. She's an American actress and author, an activist. Some of you have seen the TV show Switched at Birth. She won an award for the best actress in the movie, also called Children of a Lesser God. Go ahead. y'all seen him? This is Donald DeMarco. He was a standout star and winner of America's Top Model, Cycle 22. Also, he won the Dancing with the Stars Season 22. Go ahead. Matt Hamill. He's a deaf American martial artist and wrestler who's competed in the light heavyweight division of the UFC. His nickname is the Hammer. He beat Tito Ortiz, John Jones. He has a movie about his life called The Hammer. Go ahead. CJ Jones, that's him right there. He's a deaf actor known for his role as Joseph in the movie Did You See Baby Driver? He's also worked as a language mentor, teaching sign language to other famous hearing actors such as Jamie Foxx, Ansel Elgort, Kevin Spacey, and John Bernthal. So many. Go ahead, Kevin. Melissa Simmons. She's a deaf American actress who stars in the film Wonderstruck and the horror film A Quiet Place. For Wonderstruck, she was nominated for several awards for Best Youth Performance. I'd like to share with you 10 facts about deaf culture. In the U.S., there are around 48 million people with some hearing loss and 500,000 people who identify with ASL as their first language, like me. Do you identify as your first language, Kevin, too? What's your first language, Kevin? Kevin, which language do you prefer, English or ASL? Which is your favorite? Spanish. Spanish? So which do you prefer, Spanish, English, or ASL? All? Okay, all. My first language is ASL. People who identify with deaf using the capital D consider themselves part of a member of the deaf community and deaf culture. Deafness is not limited to age, gender, religion, or race. The deaf community is diverse and proud. Babies can use sign language to communicate their needs before they're able to speak. So what that means is if parents teach their babies how to sign, they'll can develop it later, pick it up really quickly for communication, even babies that hear. Studies have shown that signing with your baby helps with cognitive development, and teaching sign language to babies that are not deaf speeds up comprehension of spoken languages. ASL is not a simply signed version of English, which is why we say it's interpreted, not translated. It has its own vocabulary, grammar, and syntax. And just like spoken language, there's accents and regional dialects. Not every deaf person communicates in the same way. Some people prefer sign language, others can speak for themselves and lip read. When you're not sure, just ask that person. American Sign Language, voila, ASL is considered a foreign language in the U.S., even though it was created right here in America. So sometimes I've been thinking that we should have, this is a native language, because it's the same as English. It was developed here, so it should not be considered a foreign language. It's sad, though, because people think of it as a foreign language, but I don't think it is. It's here, it was developed in this country, and it needs to be a native language, not a foreign language. When using sign language to communicate, facial expressions, body language, head movements are very important to deliver the message. people are deaf. They can drive cars, they can make music, play sports, get higher education. They can do anything and everything a hearing person would do. They just do it differently. Did you know that the football huddle was first used at College for the Deaf in the 1890s so that the players could keep their signing hidden from the opposing team? This is Alexander Graham Bell. You know who he is. He developed the phone. Whatever. Go ahead. So Bell wanted to set up laws that would forbid deaf people from getting married, which he thought would also prevent the birth of more deaf children. He wanted to remove deaf teachers and the use of sign language from the classroom, and he thought speaking would be the only way to help deaf people. Are you curious what a cochlear implant is? A cochlear implant is a surgically implanted device that provides a sense of sound to someone who is profoundly deaf or severely hard of hearing in both ears. As of 2014, they've been used experimentally by some people who acquired deafness in one ear after they learning how to speak. Go ahead.
Use my language.
Just to tell y'all this while he's setting this up, if you come on Thursday and you do not have a ride home, I have bus passes that I can give you. So it's next week on Thursday. So feel free to come.
Patreon patrons, Captain Nick, recently wanted to know what the world sounds like through cochlear implants, which turns out to be a pretty popular and interesting question. Because if you don't have the implants yourself, you can't really know. Cochlear implants are one way for someone who's deaf or hard of hearing to hear speech. And to understand what they sound like, you might be tempted to put the business end of one up to a mic and listen. But if you did that, all you'd get is silence. Because cochlear implants don't actually produce any noise. Confused? Let me explain. There are two main types of devices that help people hear: hearing aids and cochlear implants. Hearing aids are basically miniaturized amps and speakers, meaning the world sounds a lot like it would to someone whose hearing isn't impaired. Of course, for a hearing aid to work, the person has to have some amount of hearing in the first place. If they don't, a hearing aid won't help. Cochlear implants allow people with profound hearing loss or even complete deafness to hear speech by bypassing most of the ear altogether. What it puts out are electrical currents, not sound waves, which is why it's silent. Cochlear implants consist of a mic, a processor, and a receiver with an electrode array. The electrodes are surgically implanted into the cochlea, in case the name wasn't clear. Your cochlea is a part of your inner ear that converts sound waves into electrical signals, which then travel to your brain through the auditory nerve. It's a hollow tube that's coiled in on itself, which makes it look a bit like a snail shell. And it's lined with special cells called hair cells that trigger nerve signals when they detect sound waves. If these hair cells aren't working because they never have or because of some kind of damage, then it doesn't matter how loud a speaker you put in your ear. You won't hear sound well, if at all. So a cochlear implant kind of acts like a hair cell replacement. The electrode array is implanted so it can stimulate parts of the cochlea directly. The mic takes in sounds from the world and passes them onto the processor, which then crunches all that sound data and interprets it into about 24 channels, each corresponding to a different frequency of sound. For each channel, there's an electrode in the array that zaps a certain spot in the cochlea. So what you hear is what your brain interprets from the combination of signals. But those sounds aren't the same as what the mic picked up. There are thousands of hair cells in a fully functional cochlea, which is why hearing people can pick up a whole range of frequencies. With only 24 channels or less, the sounds from a cochlear implant are so different that a lot of people who get them essentially have to train their brains to hear. It's impossible to completely replicate what it sounds like without zapping your cochlea, but if you've ever heard one of those talking dolls when it's running low on batteries, It's a little bit like that. The channels the implant uses are specifically designed to amplify speech and make it interpretable, but they're not great at replicating the complexity of real-world sound. As one person with a cochlear implant explained to NPR, the implants especially fail at relaying pitch and timbre. Because of that, it can be especially difficult to understand tonal languages like Chinese, or to isolate individual voices talking in a crowd. Researchers are working on ways to make cochlear implants clearer, but for now, even the best implants we have make the world sound very different. But for those who choose to get them, it's a way to listen to and understand speech, even if it sounds a bit strange. Thanks to Captain Nick for asking this question, and thanks to all of our patrons who keep these answers coming. If you'd like to submit a question to be answered,
two colleges for the deaf and hard of hearing in the U.S.
Why?
The first one is Rochester Institute of Technology in New York. Another one is Gallaudet University in Washington, D.C. Also, recently I was accepted to RIT.
Yay.
Y'all, this is the deaf applause. Go like this. Because they come here and you wave your hand so it's visual. Okay? Wait. Okay. What is so interesting about, you know, Abraham Lincoln's statue in D.C.? I'm going to show you. It's really interesting. Go carefully. You know? Don't say anything. You know. Be quiet. You've seen this. Anybody want to guess?
Is it his throat?
Yes, his hands. So, can you see here and here? The left hand is an A, and the right hand is an L. Abraham Lincoln. It's really interesting. So, there was a deaf sculptor, and he did that. Really cool. Also, another interesting thing about him, story about him, during the Civil War, there was one or two deaf soldiers.
Oh.
And one was Confederate and one was Union. And they found out about each other. They were both deaf and they were able to communicate. And they decided they were signing and socializing all day, all night. And they were on different sides. And they were searching and searching and searching. And finally they found out they were both deaf, and they thought maybe they could switch sides, but they were punished, and one of them was hung, actually.
Hmm.
And what happened is that the president, Abraham Lincoln, when he found out what happened, he went to stop the other one from dying, and actually saved him and explained to the lieutenants that they weren't sharing secrets amongst each other. They were just deaf and communicating. So that's another interesting fact about Abraham Lincoln. And this statue is in D.C. near Gallaudet University. Go ahead, Kevin. Deaf people can enjoy music. They can feel vibrations. They're very visual. Interpreters can interpret concerts, what the musicians are saying. And it's ASL is very conceptual and visual. Whoops. This is Snoop Dogg. Maybe you've seen that video of him with an ASL interpreter. Really beautiful. I don't think we can play it here. We can't play it here at school. The school won't let me open up YouTube. Okay, maybe y'all seen it. You can go home and look at it. Some common questions. Can deaf drive a car? Of course they can drive a car. We can see. We're very visual. No big deal. Can deaf enjoy music? Of course we can. And we love music. love music. It doesn't matter. I feel happy when I listen to music. I feel joy. How do you feel about being deaf? I feel really good. I feel wonderful about being deaf. I don't see a single problem. I'm proud of it. I have no problem. Are you proud of being deaf, Kevin? Yes. Why are you proud, Kevin? No, I'm not talking about driving. I'm talking about how you feel as being a deaf individual. I'm proud. He's just learning to sign, so I'm teaching him. What's it like to be a deaf person in a hearing family? It's really hard for me because they don't know how to sign. Have to use my voice, but I much prefer to be able to sign. How do you feel, Kevin, about being the only deaf person in your family? I'm fine. Be honest. In your family, you have all hearing people in your family. Do they understand you? My family speaks Spanish. Do you like it? Okay, so maybe you should explain to him, Ms. Marks. How do you feel? Do you feel good? Happy? Do you like? Is it hard for you with your mom? Can you communicate? You speak Spanish. Do you understand Spanish? Can you read your lips? So. So communication is tough with your family. It's hard. Communication is hard with his family. So what are some positive things about being deaf? That's a very common question. It's quiet. There's no noise bothering me. I can study, I can read a book, or I can have lunch and just, I don't have to hearing people talk while they're eating, and it's not a problem. I can eat, and if I need to talk, I can use my hands. Go ahead, Kevin. Do you guys have any questions for me?
Oh, I do. Do you have his implant? Does he have to change it once in a while, or does it? Is it just?
That's a good question. So I'm going to show you my implant. This part here disconnects. Okay, and then I charge it. I charge that piece. And then it's ready to go. Kevin, show yours. Here's mine. See? That way, it works. Good. So, as I told you before, I had surgery to have this put in. So can you see on this piece right here, there's a magnet. And what that means is that there's a magnet inside my head. And you look here, can you see that scar?
Mm-hmm.
That's when they implanted the magnet in my head. So I'm used to it. I just put it on there and it magnetizes to my head and then put it behind my ear.
I got
a question. Okay, hold on. When he looks up, I'm going to show you. I think he's going to show you the battery. See here? Look, there's the magnet.
Oh.
It attaches to my head. It's in my device. Obviously, very strong. Okay. You have a question?
Yeah, he can hear out of those.
Yeah, I can hear with this. So, Chris, this is me talking. If someone comes up to you and just talks, can you understand everything? Okay. With a cochlear, I can. So y'all see him, talk to him.
Oh.
If he can't hear me, Can you hear me now? What am I saying? Can't hear me. I don't understand what you're saying. If it's Dr. Cochlear, you don't understand. But you can read lips. But what's your name? So he has no idea. But watch this. Watch this. What's your name? Christopher. So can you see? You can understand.
Has he tried to teach his family members?
Yes, I've tried to teach them. They've learned some, but they know a little bit.
Is he deaf in both ears?
Who said that?
Oh, me.
Oh, sorry. My left ear, I'm fully deaf. My right ear, I have maybe a 70% loss. Would y'all like to hear what my voice sounds like?
Yeah.
Okay, so about my voice, ear. Mostly I talk to my families, so like all the time I'm concerned with my ears. I'm concerned with my ears, but my brother's sisters, so that how communicate with my families, you know, see make my voice weird, but that how
my voice
that's
weird,
not my life.
That's how I'm
my life. Yeah. So I be classy, seeing from my school, my old school, that time I was in speech therapy. A lot of time I be classy, okay. In my school and my own, I got classy, be classy too.
Use your voice, Kevin, he said. Use your voice. Kevin, talk. Hey, say, my name is Kevin Hernandez.
I don't use my voice because I have interviews, so I will have
to. You have a wonderful interpreter, right?
Yes. Yes, I don't use my voice because my interviews don't seem that I'm not, don't think I'm quiet. No, I'm just, I'm normal to see him.
Normal.
Any question?
Is it harder to make friends?
Oh yeah, and that's you. I was so a new student here.
I'm
like, it's tough for me because I mean, my first name was Ada, so I couldn't sign too because they don't know how to sign. So I started to feel like isolated.
You don't have to use your voice, you can sign.
Yeah.
I'll interpret for you.
Now, I got a new brain. I can't do talk or sign. So I'm asking the question, how do you deal with the student here? Yeah, how do you deal?
Last year, when you came to school, you were the first deaf student here at West Charlotte. Do you feel weird? Yes. Okay.
Yeah, it's tough for me.
It's tough for me, too.
Okay.
Any more questions? All right, we're going to go on. You don't have the voice. You want to voice? I'll interpret. Would y'all like to learn sign language?
Yeah.
This is me talking. I'm just showing you how to do it fast. Yeah. You want to see me do the ABC? Or my name? What do y'all want to see?
ABC.
Okay. All right. I'm going to spell. Okay. My hands need to get warm because I'm going to do it really fast.
How's he going to do it so fast?
He wants to show you. He's going to
show you. He'll sign their name. That's their project rate, too. They have to sign their name.
He's just going to show you how he does it fast, but he'll slow down and be. I'll do my name later. We're going to do the ABCs first, okay? You ready? You ready, guys? He's going to do it really good. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z.
Okay.
Good. This is apple claws.
Okay.
Oh,
here. All right.
All right, so now I'm going to sign my name. You ready? C-H-R-I-C-T-O-P-G-R. Christopher. Okay, so I tend to do it fast, and once you pick it up, you'll do it faster. So C, H, R, I, S, T, O, P, H, E, R. It's really easy. You just have to remember the shapes of her hands. Just practice doing ABCs. I'm just curious. Y'all want to practice signing your names?
How do you say how my name is?
Three people. I'd like three people to come. You want them to come up?
Can we go
three
through the alphabet first so we make sure that we show them the right alphabet?
Okay, A. Everybody do A with me. A. Thumb is up. You can have their accents. I do my thumb up. B. C. D. And I'm just throwing this in. If you're right-handed, use your right hand. If you're left-handed, use your left hand. That's a D. E. F. G. Your pointer finger's in front. H. I. J. K. I'll teach you all a trick. This is me who interpret. Make a peace sign. Put your thumb in the middle and point the middle finger forward. K. I'm going to show you. K. L. M. Your three fingers are over your thumb. N. Oh, no, N. You're doing an N. Three fingers for an M. Like the three humps in the letter M. N. Two fingers over the thumb. O. P. It's like the upside down K. Y'all remember you did a peace sign with your thumb in the middle? Flip it down. O. E. R. S. Your thumb's in front. T. U. V. W. X. Y. Z. Good. Simple. Thank you. I'd like to have three volunteers to come up and spell the name. You two, you.
Thank you.
what's your name? J-U-A-N-A. Juana?
Juana.
Juana. Juana. I'm sorry, Mr. Parker. Thank you.
Can I look at the board?
Sure. Is that, could you look at the board?
What's your name?
You did, you spelled it already, wow. You were fast.
I was gonna do my whole name, but my first name's short.
Do it again, we see.
Asia. Nicole, is it Nicole?
Mm-hmm.
Asia Nicole. Newberry?
Newberry.
Newberry. She did her full name. I'm surprised. Wow. I'm really surprised. That's really good. Okay, now you can do it. M. A. I'll help you. E. L. I. N. A. Milena?
Yes.
Milena. Melina. Great job, guys. Great work. Wonderful. Okay. Go ahead, Kevin. Kevin. The top five places that you can learn a sign language. Lifeprint.com. This is the best website if you want to write it down. YouTube channel. Called ASL Nook. The best ASL app is called the ASL app. The best TV show, Switched at Birth. Best way to learn, get involved in the deaf community. Back. The end. Finish. Thank you so much. So, would you like me to teach y'all a few like basic introductions and a few little signs? Is that okay?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm gonna let you do the teaching. I taught you yesterday, Miss Wyatt.
How do you say I need help?
Help me, help me. Help, this is help. I'm bringing it towards you. You're the one needing help. Help me.
What was this one?
Thank you. I want to see what you remember from yesterday, okay? You spell it, and I'll voice it, and she'll sign it. Okay.
Let me see.
A mother. You sign father.
That's father.
Uh-huh.
Right?
Sign mother. Man.
I'm doing both.
Okay, so father. Father, that's right.
And then man.
Man.
And then
girl. Woman. Woman.
Okay, y'all got it.
Y'all got it. You got
it. You got it. You got it.
So what was woman? Mouth to heart?
It's woman to heart. So woman is your open hand. Woman.
Gotta have a five.
Huh? And then man is up here.
Yeah.
And then, I mean, excuse me, dad is up here. Father, and then man.
Man. Thank you.
Remember Hello?
Oh, yeah.
Hello? Hello? You're helping her, Miss Marks. Sorry.
It was something.
Sorry? Did I learn that?
I didn't teach you that.
You just did that. That's good. You know how to sound sorry.
That was sorry.
Yeah. You do an S on your hand and do it in a circle on your chest. Sorry.
Oh, was it that one?
Oh, yeah.
It was like this.
Okay, let me, that's a good question. So, it just depends. There's different ways to say I love you. So the first way is I love you. That means, so like if you're in a relationship with somebody or a family member, brother, sister, parents. There's another way, which is I love you. Or you can sign like this. This means I love you. It's why it's the same
shaking.
Idea is, you know.
Are you doing the right
one? Oh, Spider-Man. You know Spider-Man.
Oh, yeah.
He does this. Just do it like this.
Because I love you.
So, just one. Can I tell him the reason why? This is for I, this is for L, and this is for Y. You put them all together. Family. F's, two F's, family. Make F's like this, okay? Touch your pointer finger to your thumb and then make a circle. Family. You're fine if you don't remember any more. It's okay. You did well. You remembered some.
Sister. Sister. It was like something there came down and did an air.
You're right, man. Sister. Girl, and then to two L's. So make your hands and two A's, right? I'm just showing you it broken down. Now make two L's. A-L. So start with your, whatever your primary hand is, on your, what's this called, jawbone. And then come down to your hand and then L's. I love my sister. Picking it up, you're doing good. Yeah, you're across. Good job. Thank you. So, if you want to learn how to sign, come to my club. It's an E2. It's from 2:15 to 3, right? Every Thursday until the end of April. And if you need transportation home, I have bus passes. Also, we have snacks. We have snacks, soda, candy, chips. So please come.
It's 2:15 to 3?
Uh-huh, and we have a sign-up paper, so we go
okay.
To the club. Where's what? Oh, it's when you come to the club. When you arrive, there'll be a sheet of paper and you sign in.
You said it's an
E2, and it's on Google Slides, and there's signs in the cafeteria. And I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to make
I thought
flyers.
This was saucy.
Okay.
I thought this was like crazy.
Oh, okay.
Oh,
So that's what y'all will do when y'all come up here and sign your name.